getting that crew together?
Yeah, trying to find the Northwest Passage.
Well, good luck to you, sonny.
I hear from the local sailors that you're planning on going to the North Pole.
Yeah, I've been planning for a while, but I haven't been able to get a ship and a crew.
I'll help you if you bring me north.
What business do you have going north?
Many sorrows have burdened me for some time now. I plan to finally resolve myself of my sins and end the pain within me.
You plan to kill yourself?
Not quite so. My intentions are much different than my ambitions.
What troubles you so?
My story contains much tragedy and horror. I do not require your belief. Only listen to it and understand what troubles me.
My mother's death marked the beginning of my treacherous life. The only thing that kept me happy was my dear, sweet Elizabeth. I loved her more than words could ever limit. Some of my best memories were made with Elizabeth back in Geneva. We used to play and laugh all day. The present made all my worries vanish. I'd be back for her someday. I'm sorry, Elizabeth.
When I reached the university, everything changed. I studied hours upon hours. My head was in my studies. My heart was in my work. I was consumed by knowledge. I had no time for anything else, including Elizabeth. I became obsessed with death and strove to discover the secret of life. Then, on one unfortunate day, I found the answer.
I found myself in the strangest of places. I left my studies and took a trip to the cemetery. What I did there was not exactly the most enjoyable task I've ever done. It was necessary for the experiment, which I was about to undertake. On a dreary night of November, that I beheld the accomplishment of my toils. My new environment consisted of a rat-infested basement, which I called my home for several months. I spent endless hours toiling over my creation, until the fateful day of my completion. That secret will be locked within me, even until death.